This is Good Morning Mumbai with Hrishi K.
Well, if you thought Sam Balsara was a doyen of advertising, I leave you to figure out what this man is. Piyush Pandey, welcome to the show, Saya.
Hi, Hrishi. Good morning to you. Lovely to be here.
My God. Hamare pet pe laat. I was just thinking that if you continue doing voiceovers the way you're going, it's going to be a threat to all of us part-time voiceover artists.
Hrishi, I'll do voiceovers for you when you're retired, because I only do, most of my voiceovers are for public service and social work.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, pandemonium, an ideal pun on Pandey, and pandemonium is out in stores. It's Piyush Pandey on advertising. Got to ask you right at the top, there are so many comparisons to real life vis-a-vis cricket. And you do say at one point that you could have gone on to actually play for the country, but you were just overawed by playing for Rajasthan. Talk about life versus cricket.
I think life and cricket go very close to each other. I don't think I would have played for the country, first of all, let me clarify. I made the level that I could reach. Life and cricket, because life is about teamwork. Life is about winning and losing. Life is about leading and being led. Life is about helping each other. So I think there's a huge comparison between, in my case it's cricket, but any team sport and life have got a lot to do with each other. And well, I played cricket in the little angan of my house, so life and cricket actually went together.
And tongue-in-cheek, you say you are getting fitted out for white flannels, you know, and you compare yourself to people like Kapil Dev or your contemporaries of the era. Not to say that the Rajasthan team was doing too badly either. There were some stalwarts who were playing.
Nine finals we played. We always lost to Bombay, but we made it to the finals. It was a great team. And it was a great opportunity for me, which I missed out on. And yes, I would like to correct you. I would never compare myself to Kapil Dev, but we played on the same team. So, no comparisons. He was a great, I was a failure. And but we played together.
Cut to childhood in Rajasthan, which keeps popping up all through your life. You talk about the storytelling that people have cultivated through the sands of time in Rajasthan. What is that thing where they open a cloth and they actually point at which frame they're talking about, almost like storyboarding? Talk about that.
Yeah, it is actually called Babuji Ki Fur. Today, the fur is sold as paintings from Udaipur. But what actually it was like a cartoon strip or a storyboard. And the beautiful thing about it was that a husband and wife, they were called Bhopa and Bhopi. They used to be together in that performance. It was normally performed at night. So lots of people from the village being there. And the lady would carry a lantern and take it from frame to frame. And the man would narrate the story in a song form. Now, they were very smart people. If they saw that the audience was losing interest, they did not go to the next frame. They switched story and went to frame number 25. I mean, they were geniuses. They didn't need research. I promise you. I hate research. But they were on the spot researchers. They say, ah, ye nahi chal raha hai. Isko aise khelte hain. And it's a great art form. It's a great song form. And I saw it from the time that I can remember. Must have been 3 or 4 or whatever.
The life and times of Piyush Pandey, pandemonium, almost like an autobiography. He doesn't call it that though, he just says Piyush Pandey on advertising. Michael Cimbello, maniac, the papa of advertising, Piyush Pandey in studio. Pandemonium, his life in advertising is out on all online stores as well as on ground stores. Go grab a copy. Breezy read. I loved every page, every word that was written. Let's come to the fact that you never just broke out on your own and started your own agency. I'm sure there are lots of people who turned around and, you know, gave you offers and said, why Martin Sorrell? You know, why Ogilvy? You're the talented man. I will fund you. I will, you know, make sure that you reach the top. Is money the problem?
I think the man who had no agenda but believes in India is a man called Anand Mahindra, a very dear friend of mine. He, at a party some 15 years back, actually called me names, saying that You are an idiot not to have your own agency. I'll give you the place, I'll give you the money. And I said to Anand, I said, Anand, you know, I have no desire. I am so happy at Ogilvy. They treat me like their son. They allow me to play my shots the way I want to play. If I break rules, they tolerate me. And I have no need. The money I am not looking after. And as I've written in the book, if you want something named after you, probably a road, but they are only done posthumously. So I wouldn't be there to see it anyway.
And even people who work on campaigns, it's always Team Ogilvy, isn't it?
It is Team Ogilvy.
There's no individual credits which is given.
We used to do it earlier, then I realized that there is a contribution from so many people that it's a dangerous thing to forget somebody.
Correct.
So we said, you know, I've narrated in the book, there's quite a famous ad I did for MCL.
Mm.
And my creative director, Abhijit Awasthi, made one little suggestion which lasted 10 seconds to tell me, but it made a world of a difference to the commercial. So, should I or should I not give credit to Abhijit? Mm. So, I think we look at that and say, no, it's very difficult to say it was the client servicing person who came up with something that sparked something in me. So, we said, we'll play it clean. It's Team Ogilvy. And internally, if you've done a great job, I'll come and give you a hug.
The big Piyush Pandey bear hug. Not to forget the fact that one of your counterparts from abroad, you'll have to tell us who it is, comes to your office and sees WPP on it and moves closer and sees Worldwide Office of Piyush Pandey. What is that?
Sir Martin Sorrell. Feared by some, but loved by me, because he loves me too. And my relationship with Martin has always been... Martin is a very enthusiastic cricketer. He's not a cricket enthusiast, because that's a bad word these days in India. He's a cricket lover. And he plays the game, plays for charity even today. So we have a relationship where I can joke with him and he doesn't mind. So that was my little prank that I played on him. He didn't have a WPP office in India that time. And he saw from far, he said WPP, and came running and saw Worldwide Office of Piyush Pandey. And he called me a cheeky bastard.
And of course, Mr. Bachchan is such an endearing partnership. And he is family to you now, isn't it? He launched the book also.
He always says that. I can only say that I'm blessed to be so close to his family and to be considered as a part of their family. I think I found a mentor, friend, guide, everything rolled into one.
Mm. And so much to learn from. You talk about, he's always on set. Once he lands up a few minutes late and he profusely apologizes. Amazing stuff.
He's amazingly disciplined. I wish, when we work together, he's the captain of the team. I'm the vice captain. It's the bloody vices I have to take out now.
The familiar Piyush Pandey sense of humor comes out. The Spice Girls and Stop, it's 9:07. Good morning. You have any comments or questions? It's HRISHIKAY on Twitter, HRISHIKAY on Facebook, facebook.com/radio1.mum. You can like the page, post on the timeline or inbox. One space, your comment or question and name to 53650 on SMS. Stop by the Spice Girls, 9:10 in the morning. Piyush Pandey on advertising. It's called Pandemonium, this wonderful book. Go pick it up. And I'm in conversation with the guru of advertising. Now let's talk about inspirations for the book. I believe there's your partner in crime, the villain of the piece, Anand Rangaswamy. He was very instrumental.
He was more than instrumental. I think the book happened because of Anand Rangaswamy. Lots of people have asked me to write a book for a long time. But this is the man who, I don't know what technique he used. He persuaded me, helped me, and convinced me. So we went down to Goa and we started talking. And he just interrogated me till the truth came out of me. So this book wouldn't have happened without Anand Rangaswamy. I'm grateful to him.
And I got to bring that discussion we had off the mic onto the mic. This beautiful place that you have in Goa. I'm not saying you have to give out the literal address. but talk about how quaint it is in terms of how away from tourist Goa it is and the three people who come visiting.
You know, it's all credit to my wife, Neeta. Because she decided that since I travel so much, why should she spend her time in Mumbai? She would much rather be in Goa and I can go there when I'm back in town. So she selected this place in a small village called Girim. Girim as in spelling, Giri as in spoken. It's a in the middle of paddy fields, say about 100 houses, little houses, all kinds of people, bullock carts, the works, no shops whatsoever. And the three guys who regularly come there every day, one is a guy who comes in the morning on a cycle. He's selling pav. He's called a poder. And he blows that blow horn and he goes. Then a similar guy comes about an hour later, he's selling fish. So he's got a different tune. He's got. Then you know it's a fish guy. And the third guy who comes there is at about 11:30, 12, which is ice cream seller who comes ringing a bell. Beyond that, there are no sellers out there. Once a week, there's a gari of cooking gas that comes. And it's beautiful place. People put money and their empty cylinders outside their house. The guy comes, takes the money and the cylinder, places the new cylinder and goes away. There is no interaction because that guy's gone to work. And there is no theft. So far, so good. I think it's a beautiful place to be in. Lots of birds of the right kind. my wife lives there, so it can't be any other kind. It's beautiful. I do a lot of creative work there. And this book was conceived in Goa with Anant Rangaswamy over 1 week of working 12 hours a day.
Lovely. Okay, the questions have started coming in. Jayant Bokre, can you ask Piyush Pandey about his view on the future of radio in India as a creative man? Radio is very close to your heart, isn't it? When you started off so much radio, my God.
You know, my first exposure to advertising was on radio. My sister used to do radio spots in Jaipur and I was in college. And she used to give me $50 for doing chorus and singing songs like Meri Ghar Ki Raksha Karta Jan Santala. I think the future of radio can only be bright and bright and bright. It's a localized medium. It caters to the sentiments of people who live in a certain area. It has the touch that mass media of the other kind may not have the ability. I think radio has tremendous thing. And we are a country of sounds. We are a loud country. We love laughing. We love singing. We love crying louder than the Westerners do. So anything to do with audio, and radio is a great audio medium. And with the youngsters like yourself, Rishi, who keep people entertained in between the other sounds, I think radio has a huge future.
Lovely. Utsav Chaudhary on Twitter. Question for Piyush Pandey. I don't think it's true for the entire industry, but anyway, I'll read this out. Can the fragmented advertising industry with a low cost model still attract the best talent with low pay?
I think it's a very important question that we have to ask ourselves, and we have to ask that question of our clients. If you pay peanuts, you'll get monkeys. And we need better people to deliver better to our clients. And the more we get fragmented, I think we have to see, fragmenting is like branding. When there are niche brands, you pay more for it. When you go and buy a pair of glasses which you want, which are not available everywhere else, you pay more for it. I think we have to pay for our people, because without people, there is nothing else that we own in the advertising industry. And without people, the clients will suffer, not just us.
Absolutely. Okay, messages in back with Piyush Pandey. We're going to put up dashing pictures of Piyush on Twitter as well as Facebook, HRISHIKAY on both platforms, facebook.com/radio1.mum. You can see them on the timeline. You can tweet and post back any questions or reactions to this. It's 9:15, messages in back. 94.3,
this is Good Morning Mumbai with Hrishi K.
Piyush Pandey is in studio. We're talking about his life and times. It's Pandemonium. Piyush Pandey on Advertising, the book, which is his debut novel, which is out in studios. It gives you a comprehensive view of his life till now. He's just at the quarterway mark. Lots more to come. Jitin Bhagat. Piyush Pandey, I love this man's sense of humor. Besides having great respect for what he has achieved, it's a punny show today, Hrishi K. Thanks very much. Elizabeth, the Supremes, nice playlist as usual. Thanks very much. Okay, now let's come to the fact that you've always encouraged people to do social service films, not so much films for awards, which seems to be kind of like an obsession with the advertising industry. So talk about your views on that.
I think there's so much to be done in this country, and I have actually tried to have a word with all my creative heads that own one thing. Don't try and do a one-off to win an award somewhere. You won't make a difference to the society. So own something. So there is a team of mine that has decided to own Mumbai Police. They've already done about 15 films for Mumbai Police. We do it gratis. We do it from the heart. And they run it nicely. I said, associate with people who are serious about what they're doing. Personally, I'm very involved with Cancer Patients Aid Association and Jaipur Fort and the works. So we all try and do something. If somebody owns something for 2-3 years in a row, I think the passion grows. Instead of doing one ad here and win an award and get along with it, you don't even feel it. Social service has to be done with a feeling. It has to be owned. And that's what I try and share with my colleagues.
I want to take you back to Mile Sur Mera Tumhara. There's immense pride when you talk about that. And you say how your mother said that your dad would have been so proud.
Yes.
Talk about that. Amazing. I mean, I grew up as a kid watching all those stalwarts, whether it's Pandit Bhimsen Joshi or Balamurli Krishna or Prakash Padukone, Shavana Azmi in Mile Sur Mera Tumhara. The story of that.
See, my parents were not very convinced about what is it that I'm doing. What is a tea taster's job? What is an advertising job? They'd never known anybody else do these jobs. So they were very concerned. And then 1985, I lost my father. And 87, late Suresh Malik gave me the opportunity of writing the lyrics for Mile Sur Mera Tumhara. And then it became like a national anthem. And that's the time my mother used to cry and say that, I wish your father was around. He would have gone and told his friends, do you know this is what my son does?
How
so
amazing.
It was an opportunity of a lifetime. I don't know why Suresh gave it to me. I was not a big writer. But I thank him that he did.
Also, how growing up as a child, carpenters were such an inseparable part of your life, which just helped you in your advertising career. I mean, especially with the work for Pidilite.
I think I was blessed by God. I had no idea as to where I'm going to go in my life. But I think God decided, get to know the carpenters now, because later on you'll be working on Fevicol. I could write a chapter on barbers. I love talking to people on the streets, because there's so much knowledge, so much wisdom, so much street culture that comes so handy in advertising. I didn't know I would be in advertising, but I love talking to people. That middle class background that I came from gave me the opportunity, because these people used to come home. My parents didn't have the money to buy ready-made stuff, so they used to call one guy and say, bana do furniture. My father used to go to Agra. He had a friend out there, nine bachche hain, for nine of them, if I buy 9 pairs of shoes, how much discount will I get? So I think it was beautiful. I think the message in this book for everyone is that enjoy your environment, enjoy your society, enjoy your family. There is a gold mine of ideas out there. You don't have to read Piyush Pandey's book.
Well, I suggest you read Piyush Pandey's book. It's Pandemonium. Dire Straits, The Bug, 9:29. Good morning. With the doyen of advertising, Piyush Pandey in studio. Sometimes you're the windshield, sometimes you're the bug. Dire Straits, The Bug. Okay, Deepak Saluja. Mohammad Khan and Piyush Pandey, the pillars of Indian advertising. Thank you for that, Deepak. Jason Lewis, amazing listening to Piyush. Can't wait to get pandemoniumed. Deepak, if AB is the angry man, Piyush is the funny and creative young man. Jason, question for Piyush Pandey. Does emotional connect in advertising always work in India? Or is there a flip side to it? Interesting question, because you've dealt with that here. Saying there was a gentleman, was it French, who came and said, I don't like the Vodafone Pug commercial?
Yes.
Talk about that.
Yeah, I believe that the difference between an animal and a human being is that we have emotions. Otherwise, we would still be living in caves. There is something which is beyond rational, which is magical about a human being. And I think, therefore, emotion works in advertising. Yes, Neil French was a Britisher, and he wanted to see stuff which was cutting to the extent of, if we had killed the dog at the end, he would have loved it. But we are emotional people. There's nothing so successful as the pug commercial that happened. It touched the hearts of people. I don't think advertising should be so insular and so internal that only we appreciate it. I have always said to my people, if I have to go and explain an ad to my neighbor, then I've lost the game completely. So I think emotion works, and emotion, as we know in India, the Navrasas in our culture and in our dance forms and singing forms. So emotions can range from humor to what they call vibhits. Vibhits means disgust, to shringar, to hasya, to whatever. So if there are 9 emotions, I think you can do advertising for 9 lifetimes very easily.
Shuddh Shakahari, Nikal 5 rupay, very quick, epic copy, he says. Anand Kadkol just tuned into Piyush Pandey and You Friday just got so much better. JP Shetty, why is so much great talent from great ad companies leaving? They're starting their own firms. Big companies, do they restrict creativity? He completely disagrees. Tell him about having an office full of people. That's interesting.
Yeah, I was just talking to Rishi and I said, I love the entire idea of having so many people around. There's so many ideas around. There's so many cultures around. There's so many ages around you. This is great fun. And when it comes to Ogilvy and Mather, we are the largest advertising company, and I think you will agree that we do good creative work. So I don't think they work against each other. And the day you start behaving like that, that you're too big to do good creative work, I think you should shut down. That's what I believe.
Madhu S. Datta, oh my God, you made my day hearing my ever favorite Piyush Pandey. Anand Rangaswamy was waiting for this book since you mentioned it. Okay, JP Shetty, question. How did different agency people like Sam Uncle, Prasoon and Piyush get together for the BJP campaign? Now, that's really exciting. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a song and come back and talk about that. Prakash Nair, one of those days when good music is an interruption. I agree, buddy. But I got to play the music. Michael Learns to Rock, Sunday, 9:36. One shot, that entire video. Michael Learns to Rock, Sunday at 9:40. Piyush Pandey is in studio. Okay, JP Shetty's question. How did different agency people get together for the BJP campaign? In particular, it's been such a fascinating campaign and you really worked your butt off on it, didn't you?
Yes.
You and the team.
Yeah, my team did a fabulous job and we all rolled up our sleeves. There was just complete teamwork that happened there. My interaction was largely with Sam because bulk of the campaign was done by us and Sam was the Sam's Medicine was the buying agency, so our interactions were very frequent, but we were doing two different jobs. We were creating, and Sam was making sure that people get to see what we create. So it's not that we were working together in the same room, but were we working together in spirit? Yes, Sam and I worked very closely on this.
Okay, now I'm going to come to one campaign which is a personal favorite. I remember I was doing a bit of commentary for the IPL for Sony, and Arun Lal and myself were in the commentary box together. And when the Zuzus first came on, Arun said with immense pride, he said, you know, this is it. This is Piyush.
It wasn't Piyush, it was Rajiv Rao.
Okay, yes, which is you say in the book.
Yeah.
Now, what I want to know is pushing that idea through, and that's where you say people like Harit Nagpal are also heroes.
Yeah,
talk
absolutely
about pushing that idea through, the Zuzus.
I think they created, they owned the idea as a team. I know that fantastic story that when they were sitting together, Harit and his team, Kavita and our team with Hepzibah and Rajiv and gang, somebody said that there are going to be some 56 matches or whatever matches, 2 a day. If we do a great commercial also, won't people get bored of it? We'll be running it so often. And I think Hepzibah said, why don't we do one commercial per match? A completely outrageous statement. And they all said, yes, let's do it. And then poor Rajiv Rao went through hell to create 30, 40 commercials. And to think of an idea which keeps getting refreshed every day and yet holds it together, I think it's milestone for Indian advertising. And I have always said that I wish I had some role to play apart from being the overall general captain of the team. I didn't get to bat in that one.
And this is not pure animation. It was diminutive people inside wearing those
South African girls because they are petite, so you have to wear that huge suit and then perform. I think it's just magic that happened.
And there are some karmic connections. People who keep coming and going out of your life and people who keep coming back. Harit Nagpal comes back in Tata Sky. What is it, a 4-minute commercial?
Yeah, he does a 4-minute commercial and then he goes and creates a series of ads which ran in IPL for I don't know how many years. It was a 13-part serial of a love story in Kashmir on their daily recharge. Just this one. Harit Nagpal is a complete front foot player. he doesn't want to play the game people play normally. He wants to make the difference.
Come on now. Get your questions coming in. One space, your query and name to 53650 on SMS. On Twitter, it's HRISHIKAY. On Facebook, it's HRISHIKAY. As well as facebook.com/radio1.mum. You can like the page. You'll see them on the timeline. You got these messages. So enough time for you to do stuff. I'm going to put up more pictures of Piyush Pandey in studio. 9:44. Messages in back.
94.3 Radio 1. This is Good Morning Mumbai with Hrishi K.
Piyush Pandey is in studio and a wonderful hour spent here with him. Now listen, you're going to tell me about a song called Waka Waka.
Yes.
And your history of this, and the lovely Neeta, your wife, also plays a very, very important part in this.
Yeah, she keeps surprising me all the time. She will bring out things and say, Piyush, have you looked at it this way? Piyush, have you looked at it that way? And yesterday, she zapped the hell out of me. And I was not the only one. There were three other friends in that room. And she said, do you know the words of Waka Waka?
Okay.
I said, no, I know that. Waka Waka,
hey.
And I remember Shakira's movements.
The hips don't lie.
And nobody actually knows that it is probably one of the most beautiful motivational songs that has been written. I'm going to use it for a training program.
Very good.
I'll read out some words to you. And this is and all listeners, all friends of mine, I want to say that don't layer things so much that something beautiful gets hidden behind just the rhythm or somebody's movement. The words have got lost in that song, but the words are beautiful. The words read. The moment has arrived, the walls fall. It's going to start, the one fair game. The kick doesn't hurt, fear doesn't exist. Dust yourself, stand up and get back in the ring. And the pressure is felt, your people wait for you. Now let's go for all and luck is with you. And so on, it goes on. When I read the words and she played a karaoke to me yesterday and said, Piyush, read these words. Did you ever know these words? And I felt such like an idiot that I had never bothered to know. But maybe the music director never bothered to make sure that we hear these beautiful words. So all those who love this song, I have a request. Go read the words. You'll find beauty of life in it.
Jimmy Karumalil, I'm sure there's a Mallu hand behind scripting the international roaming Zuzu ad. How else does one explain Puttu Kadle Kappa mean in it? Answer that.
That is the magic of Prakash Verma. Yes, I think there is a Mallu hand, a Mallu voice. Something, I think when you see my ads, you'll see a little bit of Rajasthan comes out a little more than other things. And I think that's Prakash Verma. And all the voiceovers were done by the director, that's Prakash Verma. He's the one who wanted to be an RJ, never became one, so he thought it was a chance to do the voiceovers.
Anon, your Twitter handle. I agree with Piyush Pandey. Harit Nagpal really makes a difference. The first responsive head of Tata Sky. Garvita Bisaria, my day will be made if Piyush can talk a little about how the legendary Mile Surd Mera Tumhara came about. He talked about it. I'm so sorry you tuned in late.
The man who would have told you a little more about it would have been Suresh Malik. Unfortunately, he's no more. I only wrote the lyrics. He conceived the ad.
Anand, very generous of Piyush to credit his team, bucks the usual impression that advertising has come to symbolize. Rajit Desai, please do ask the great man about his Chal Meri Luna campaign and cricket days in college. Come on, Chal Meri Luna.
Cricket days in college were absolutely fantastic. I actually scored a lot of runs. It was only in Ranji Trophy that I thought I was a rock star and failed very badly. And Chal Meri Luna is perhaps the most beautiful experience of my life. It's my first big campaign. The account was given to me by other creative people who thought it was a boring account, so they gave it to me. And I went there and found in Arun Ferodia a masterman. I read out three ads to him, and he didn't say a single word while I was reading out. He just kept chewing onto his little toothpick, and I thought, I've miserably failed. And then he just says the first few words. After that, he says, अच्छे तीनों बना दो. I have not heard better magical words in my life. And then there were people who helped me make it. And there came the opening scores of Piyush Pandey's innings.
Awesome time with Piyush Pandey. It's magic listening to him, says Deepesh Pansal. Mera Ghosh, someday, I'm glad you like that one. Pratyush Sinha, Piyush sir is so people friendly. Then why is he not on social media? I was going to ask that question.
He just asked me this question in the staircase about 3 minutes back. And I just told you, I'm too dangerous a guy for social media. I speak my mind out. And these days, if you speak your mind out too much, you can get into trouble. I don't want cops in my house. I don't want to hurt people. So the day I believe that I am able to discipline myself, I will first write it with a pen on a paper and then put it onto the text of an internet or whatever. But yes, I know myself. So I will be careful.
For Piyush Pandey, says Shrikesh, I'm sure the quaint village in Goa has its own charm, but for a man who loves observing people, the morning Shivaji Park walk is the best place, ain't it? Around Shivaji Park, you get to see so many characters.
I have seen the most beautiful. I am a fairly good walker at Shivaji Park. Yeah. I don't know if you have seen me there.
Maybe that's why.
One of the most beautiful things I saw, and I keep observing a lot at Shivaji Park, there were three Sardar gentlemen, very senior, must have been in their 70s. And one of them was slightly fitter than the others. So the other two were sitting on the side wall, and this man was getting them to exercise. I have never seen a better visual effect of friendship and helping each other. I am very touched. One day I will use it in an ad.
Pandemonium is in stores. Go get your copy now. Thank you so much, Piyush Pandey, for spending the hour in studio with me.
Thank you, Rishi. I will not copy you like some people do. Rishi is Rishi and only one Rishi.
How wonderful of you to say that. It's Waka Waka Shakira. Up ahead, the Pyar Ka Panchnama 2 cast. It's 9:57. My name is Rishi K. Good morning.